Hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel English Learning with Lori. Today I'm going to read two stories in the Old Testament. First, Cain and Abel's story, and the second is Noah's Ark. Cain and Abel. The man and the woman settled down together in the world outside the Garden of Eden. They work hard to get their foods, just as God had said they would have to do. They often felt tired and hungry, but now they knew that if they stopped working, there would be no food for them to eat. Often they quarreled. It was very difficult from the happy life they had led in Eden. But although they had spoiled their friendship with God, He still loved them, He still looked after them, though they did not always realize it. After a while, the woman became pregnant and had a baby son. The woman and the man had names now. The name called his wife Eve, and she called him Adam. They decided to give their son a name too, and they called him Cain. Later on, they had another son, and they called him Abel. As they grew up, the two boys had to help their parents with the work. Cain used to grow vegetable and wheat, while Abel looked after the flock of sheep and goats. Because of the evil that had come into the world when Adam and Eve disobeyed God, they were not happy family. Cain was often jealous of Abel and sometimes hated him secretly. One day, when they were both grown up, they decided to give God a present. They built a mound of stones to put their present on. Then Cain brought some of his vegetable and grain, and Abel brought a lamb, carefully choosing the best of his flock. God was more pleased with Abel's present than with Cain's, because Abel had given the best he had. Cain noticed this and scowled angrily. "Don't look so angry," God warned Cain. "But temper can make you hurt other people. It will get the better of you if you let in." Cain was too jealous and angry to listen. "Come into the field," he told Abel, and there he killed his brother. At once he heard God ask, "Where is your brother?" "How could I know?" replied Cain. "Why have you done these dreadful things?" "You have murdered your brother," said God. "Now you must leave this place. You can no longer grow your crops in the soils where your brother lies dead." So Cain had to go away from his sad parents, but God still looked after him whenever he went. At last, he settled in a distant land where he built a city and raised a family of his own. Many hundreds of years went by. The world began to fill with people, but they were wicked. They robbed and killed each other until God felt sorry that He had ever made human beings who treated one another so badly. He was angry at the wrong He saw. At last, there was only one man left who still loved God and followed His way. His name was Noah. So God warned Noah, "People are so cruel that they are destroying one another and my beautiful worlds. I am going to send lots of rain. All the lakes and rivers, even the sea itself, will overflow and rush over the earth until every living thing has been drawn in the flood. I promise I shall keep you and your family safe. God continued, you must build a boat. God told Noah exactly how the boat was to be made. It was to be built of a special kind of wood and was to have 3 decks. The whole boat was to be 150 meters long and it was to be coated inside and outside with tar to make it watertight. Noah obeys God's instruction down to the smallest details. His whole family helped him. Every day, astonished crowds watched them as they cut down trees and smoothed the wood. Slowly, the boat began to take shape. But the bystanders jeered, "Noah is mad." They said, "There is no water here to float a ship." Noah took not the slightest notice. Then God told him to drive into the boat 2 every kind of animals, birds, and reptile. So Noah and his family rounded up the animals and drove them in. 2 by 2, 1 male and 1 female, tigers, elephants, sparrows, and mice, all had to be aboard before the rain came. When the animals were safely settled in the boat, Noah and his family went aboard too. They took a last look at the old world. Then God himself shut the door behind them. The thunder. There was a flash of lightning and a crash of thunder. The dark, swollen clouds that filled the sky burst and began to rain. Water poured down the hills and filling the valleys, rose higher and higher. The big boat jolted and began to drift, gently floating on the flood. Everywhere people tried to escape, faster and faster rose the boat on the foaming, swirling water until it was tossed high above the top of the highest mountain. Every living thing on earth drawn as the sea covered the whole world. Inside, Noah and his company were crowded and a bit cramped. The family was busy from morning until night, cleaning the pens, changing the straw, bringing food and water to the animals. They looked after them all, especially the ones that were seasick, and they even found them to play with their new friends. For 40 days and 40 nights, the sound of rain continued overhead, but God did not forget Noah and the animals in the boat. At last, the rain died away over the flooded world. Slowly, the water went down, until at last the boat came to rest on the top of the double peak mountain called Ararat. The wind kept blowing. Soon, the peak of the other mountains showed like rock sticking out of the sea. Noah opened a trap door and looked about. He decided to send a raven out to investigate. The bird gave a harsh croak and flew away. It never came back to the boat, but circled the flooded country looking for somewhere to rest. So a little later, Noah sent out a dove. Everyone gathered round to watch as the bird shook its white feather and flew off, but it found nowhere to settle and came back to the boat. A week later, Noah tried again. All day the family watched anxiously. Then, in the evening, the bird came back. Everyone cheered when they saw that the bird held an olive leaf in its beak. Now they knew the tree was beginning to grow. Soon they would be able to leave the boat and make a fresh start in God's new world. At last, the day came when God said to Noah, "You may let the animals out now." with a flurry of feathers and pounding of hoofs. They rushed out of the boat and raced away to find new homes. Last of all, Noah and his family stepped shakily out of the boat, taking gulps of fresh air and stretching arms and legs. It was good to be alive in this clean new world, as a way of saying thank you to God for this fresh start. Noah built a mound of stones and offered some birds and animals to him. The God said to Noah, "I will never send another flood to destroy the world. Until the end of time, there will always be times to plant and times to harvest, hot weather and cold weather, day and night." God told Noah and his family and all the living things about this promise. "Look, I am putting my bow in the sky so that you will remember my promise. When the rainbow shines again, stormy clouds, you will know that I am reminding you that I shall never again send a flood to destroy the earth." A wonderful colored ark glowed in the sky. Noah and his family went singing on their way under the rainbow. The end. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channels. And do not forget also to click the bell button for your notification.